He's a poor thing. I think he was wanted to drink something or eat something or something.
Third show of the first day of Latin Fashion Week Winter Festive Collection, and we're so glad it's with an amazing designer, somebody who's always there to light up all things Latin Fashion Week, Sohaya.
Thank you.
For a great collection, you stuck to your fashion sensibilities. We know how you love your grays and the blacks and the whites, and we saw that the representation of it come alive this season as well. You have a very...
First of all, I want to thank my team who just came together, B Blanc and Fatmo, and all the amazing people who worked for me. Shushan, Prateek, Bhavna, you know, Marka. There she is, amazing. You know, Jason, everyone to represent. So by Felicia basically means dismissing the irrelevant, just not listening to what other people say and just being who you are. And I think that is so important today when we're all so judgmental and we're always spewing hate at other people, you know. And just, I think the ability to be who you are and love yourself automatically just makes the whole world a better place.
Yes.
And simply put, that's all I was trying to kind of get out today.
It was a great show. You could hear everybody just like wooing and cheering and everything. The fact that you had showstoppers looking so, you know, like out of their shell. It just was a great visual treat for every audience members. Prateek, you look so unique.
Thank you.
Sushan,
I
love the entire the detailing that has gone into it. It's beautifully portrayed. Prateek,
yes.
Start off with you.
Sure.
How is it like, you know, getting into the Saptar? What was it like when Sohaya came up to you and said that, so this is my concept?
You know what? I have to break it to you that I volunteered.
Yeah.
I volunteered for this. So we were actually at dinner and and Chola says, you know, having a show and this and that. I'm like, oh, okay, so what's it about? She says, about drag. And everyone's doing it, so hang on, can I do it? I actually wanted it. I'm like, Chola, can I do it?
I mean, his face is half shaved, so imagine.
So but she was apprehensive because, like, hey, listen, you have to dress up drag, you have to have drag makeup and stuff like that. Are you okay? Is it a good kind of, is it a good space for you? I said, absolutely, yes, I'm jumping. I absolutely jumped in. Because, you know, just her representing gender fluidity and all of us have so many, you know, we have so many gay friends,
yeah,
and lesbian friends, and there's so many, you know, people who dress drag are so close to us. And we just want to have fun with them. We love them, you know, it's about loving and loving, you know, and that's why we wanted to do this and just, you know, represent each other and do this together and just have one hell of a time. I think we've managed to do that. I think we've had one hell of a time.
I think that was exactly what was coming off on the ramp as well. Why the energy of the show was just bar none.
Absolutely.
What a great way for, you know, kicking off Lakme Fashion Week was such a good show. So Shan, I would love to hear from you. Like Prateek just mentioned, you know, like completely erasing the lines of gender fluidity. Like,
right,
it shouldn't have to be age, number, your size, everything is now, it doesn't come under a particular bracket.
Right.
And a conversation like this is so relevant in today's day and age because we need to really, like, educate the audience about so many things. How passionate and how involved were you when Sohaya came to you with this?
So first of all, I think it's a great step that you've taken to include drag in on the runway, which happens everywhere around the world, but like this is the first time it's happening here, so thank you. And that's amazing because I perform, and so does Mark, all over the world, literally. And then we were just like, okay, everybody everywhere is doing drag and we're not doing it. And then, okay, now that you just shut me up.
That's all.
And yeah. And no, because when I was on Big Boss, I wanted to do drag. And then I was just like, oh, I don't know how they'll react and stuff. But then I saw Courtney Act, who's a drag queen, winning Big Brother UK. And I was like, girl, that was my idea. She stole it.
Mm-hmm.
They stole everything. They stole the Kohinoor.
Yeah.
My name is Rani Kohinoor, my drag name. And I just jumped. I was like, are you serious? And she's like, I want you to perform also. I was like, I'm coming. Tell me when. I'm staying with you. So I just loved it. Absolutely loved it. And the energy was crazy.
Yeah.
I just absolutely thought.
That's so amazing.
I was like, wow.
Wow.
So yeah.
So, hi, coming back to you actually, shows like RuPaul's Drag Race are so big. They have a platform to really showcase, you know, the best of the best. When you were conceptualizing the term Bi Felicia, because that's something that's so, you know, it hits a note when Cookie says it. What was the inspiration between, like, why Bi Felicia?
I actually did watch a lot of RuPaul's Drag Race, and I just realized that there's so much, like, you know, everyone's a human being, no matter what you are, gay, straight, drag, whatever. And that's the most important, that's the basic thing that everyone must address and recognize, you know. And everyone has so much talent, and when you look at drags, you know, they always look happy and they're always performing. There's also such a, maybe another story behind it, you know. It's so difficult to kind of come out there and be different and not be judged.
Yeah.
So that was actually just that was the fundamental, I think, thought behind the show I did. And everyone I spoke to, from Roma, who was doing jewelry, you know, and Ashwin, who was doing music, the hair, the makeup, everyone was just, they identified with it so much that everyone wanted to be a part of it, you know. So I think basically that's what you need. You need love and just get rid of hate.
Absolutely.
It's so simple,
absolutely.
You know.
Love and let love. I think that's our tagline for sure. I think it should be love and let love.
Taking a page from RuPaul's Drag Race, my last line to you is going to be, you guys can stay, I'm going to sashay away and open the
We love you.
To media questions, guys, if you have any questions to ask. Okay, as always, they're going to keep it for the one-on-ones. Fine then, I think I'm done here.
Okay.
Thank you so much for the time, thank you so much for the
I
show.
I think you are one of the most intellectually
yes.
sound...
Yes, she's done her research, honey.
My God.
You for AVM.
Mark.
Yeah. I'm just gonna request you guys to come to.
Yes.
Yes. Look at
Ronnie. Hold on.
Yes.
Okay.
Look here.
Look here.